Last time, on totally almost 3 hours, I talked about the breaststroke technique. And I don't want to start over there or things, but if necessary, I do. What do you think? Just roughly, just the short things about breaststroke technique.
Yeah, okay.
Because, you know, we spend, again, 3 hours, I cannot talk about the trainings and the dry runs and exercises, but just quickly, on 1977, I was coach one year, and I worked with the breaststrokers, and I was breaststroking myself, and I thought something not perfect in the breaststroke anywhere, and let's figure it out something, because I knew the breaststroke will be different after 30 years than right now, right? Somebody will do something different. Why not we figure it out something new? And the easiest way, if you see the tendency, how was the evolution in breaststroke from like 1950s? What was the difference? And another things, find the mistakes in the best breaststrokers stroke, because you know everybody saw the best breaststrokers in any time. Always said, this is perfect, this is nice, this. You know, you can find mistakes everywhere. You know, it's not a big deal. But the another question, that after you find the mistakes, what the solution to fix it? But you can do something better, different, and better. And that time, the breaststroke was pull kick, and I figured out it's a relatively big dead point after the pull and before the kick. And I said, let's do something, because here was the pull part, here was the kick part. Doesn't matter if it's something bigger, but if somebody has a better kick, this part is longer. Somebody better pull, this part longer. And I said, get here between. And I said, let's do something between. Like make a tie between the two movements. And the idea was, what can we do after the pull when the kick is not coming? So that let's do an active movement, like a lunge forward with the upper body, with the shoulders, with everything. And finally, I tried to, you know, make these things in my swimmer, and from the side, the shoulders make a, like a wave shape. This was the reason why it was wave breaststroke. But the idea, the most important thing was how we can do constantly speed in the breaststroke. Because every other stroke, mostly in the backstroke and freestyle, it's really easy to do a constant speed. But in the breaststroke, still not perfect. And this was the idea. I don't want to talk about that because to anybody, it doesn't make any sense. And but some really, really important point in this movement. You know, the swimmer set the speed already after the dive, or after the push of the wall. And our goal is just for the same speed on the way through. Because the stroke speed will be slower than the push and the dive speed. Well, it's really, really hard. You know, relatively, our sport seems not so complicated, because the soccer, hockey, and every other sport is really, really complicated, because first of all, we are alone, absolutely alone. Nobody bothers, you know, maybe the base, maybe the water. The water is our friend. And, but the goal is how we can make one good stroke and how we can repeat it all the way through on the whole distance. This is really hard. This is really hard to do it. But the first step, the first important thing is how you can make one good stroke. This is what we do first of all. Of course, same time we have been training, physical training, different trainings, but there's one good strokes. Well, the strokes, of course, like I said, is not perfect, but it's different a little bit for everyone because every swimmer has been different. Some are shorter, some taller, skinnier, or more skinnier, and you know, long arms, short legs, doesn't matter. But the physics is physics for everyone because we have the same goal and we have the same. We have a body, we have water, we have to do the same distance and the rules same for everyone. How we can make something good faster than everybody else? It's only two things, not only two things. Technical and physical things. The technical, not easier, but sometimes to prove technically, the solution technically pay back easier than the physical thing. Because you know, if you need stronger, faster, more endurance the swimmer, you need more time. Sometimes year by year by year. But many times you can fix the technique a minute, a day. Sometimes not. I tell you to choose my best swimmer, learn like 1.5 years. Every day, I didn't do it. I said, no, this is wrong. But it's really too stable thing, but what can I say? I cannot tell him something to do it, not. And sometimes I was lucky, was it one and a half months was enough, but it depends. But we have not too many choices because we have a swimmer, and it's talented and not talented, and how talented, if someone, you know, is a talented range, and you cannot do, you know, anything else, just work, not give up. Well, go back to the technical things, shortly. First of all, the body position. The body position should be just, maybe I can show something, and quickly. This is the ideal on 1977 on the real desktop. My friend from Japan knows it because I made a lecture in 1989 and he was my translator in Japan, in Tokyo. I showed the same thing over there. And my idea, 95% same, it was, because you can say many things, but you have to prove it. Everybody can do different things, everywhere. It's your choice. Sooner or later, you get to prove it. And this picture made me in the training camp, because you see she at the beginning. It's not yet there. Yeah. Of course not yet there, because I didn't. I'm just showing for myself. Base position is almost the same for every swimmer as in every strokes. Not perfectly, but bottom line is water level up. Water level up. The body should be like this. And every body part important. Somebody facing too much, we'll sink. Somebody feet like this, water will push up. And somebody take their arms this way, nobody will follow. Hands totally different. But this is the goal. It's really, really hard to do in each stroke in breaststroke. Because let's go. So I forgot about the trainings. If somebody tired from the trainings after the first 1 hour or almost 2 hours, we cannot fix the strokes. We cannot tell, okay, you do perfect breaststroke because not really possible. Many times the training is only for the training, for the engine, and not for technique. And also you have to know exactly what you need to tell for the swimmers, always coming from the easy game. What the swimmer is able to fix right now when the swimmer is already tired. But cannot say, okay, you do your best stroke. When? Now, right now, your best stroke. But it's not really, of course, perfect, but I think the breaststroker's stroke, I think the further than any other stroke from the personal best all the time in the workout. Like a 50 freestyle can send a really good freestyle technically almost any time. And all that's the similar also. Butterfly, it's easy on the short distance, like 25. Many times if you say, okay, guys, now 8, whatever, 25, free choice, almost every single is the butterfly because it's easy on feet. And the stroke also not bad. Nobody really wants to swim breaststroke in diet. Not accident, it's because it's, you know, a good breaststroke is a good feeling. A bad breaststroke is a terrible feeling. You know, somebody tired and having not a good stroke, swim a 200 breaststroke in the race, it's a hell. It's terrible. But in the good shape, the good technique, this is a beautiful thing. Well, let's go back. I think we have to here. It's almost the same thing. It's good because it's in the stroke, in the sim, in the strokes. It's same thing here when we try first of all and I fix the mistake. You can see the hands not on the right spot, the head to be and the body a little bit too high, and the toes not anything. It's easy to show for the swimmers if you have underwater camera, underwater case. This is not a big deal. This is the iPad with the underwater case. You can put it in, a couple of seconds, you can show for yourself first of all. You can show for the swimmers, because the best thing to correct any technique if you show for the swimmers. Sometimes I call this is the punishment. Come over and watch yourself. This is the punishment. And because it's honest. Oh, this is a new thing in 1977. This picture from 1979, only before the Olympic Games. And that time the rule was really different because one small step had to above the water in every stroke. So that after 1986, December 31st of the change, and now it's much easier. This is the water, half catch of water. Must be with straight arms. And then the swimmers starting the pool, starting the stroke. Head and the whole body should be in the streamline. I will be a little bit quicker than not last time, but is it not necessary enough? You see the arms straight, still straight, and the palm is turning out. This is very important part because if you don't turn out your palm, you have not surface. This way you have, but the most important things in the breaststroke, don't use your pool or lift only toward the pool. And last time was a very small question, how you can come up. Like my question was backwards, why you need to come up? Who said to come up? Come up because you have to breathe. And how high? Only one reason to come up so high, this is the additional later. If you can move over the surface with your widest body part, your shoulders. If not, no any sense to come up survive. because doesn't matter, you know, I said that let's do something like the wave, because this is nice wave if you move in the same speed. But you are somewhere faster, the wave will be something like something slower, the wave is like this. You can check out the speed is in the stroke same, constant or not. But you don't need to come up so highly. The maximum is your upper body. You cannot. No. Sorry. Hello? You cannot up higher your shoulder than the upper arm, because this is the rule, you need to move on the surface. And lower, you can do lower. You can do just almost on the surface. If you want, if you're able to, you know, move over the surface in a long way, you come up higher. If not, no way. But when you are reaching forward, don't sink. This is the most important thing. Don't sink. If you cannot hide it, don't. But don't sink. And last time I said same thing. I don't know what happened exactly in the last 30 years, 25 years. But now technically the woman breaststroke is better than the man. It's never happened in many strokes. Technically, as I think it's up to the coaches. Up to the coaches. Lisa Jones was second singer of the first. He was better than the boys, not the next, now the second generation stayed better than the boys. Because the boys use more power in technical things. And also, we talk about the 100 and 200 time of us in progress. This shows same thing in the breaststroke, mostly the breaststroke. Let's go back to the me. Well, and last time was I told you the smart question, how somebody come up if doesn't use the pool. If somebody use the pool only for pool purpose, you will use a little bit for lift also, but you don't want to do it, okay? Don't, not purposely. And if you have a good speed or a water catch, if you arch your back a little bit, water will push up, control it. It's enough. And also, and then when you finish with the pull in the in-sweep time, at the same time you have to lift up your shoulders purposely after your head. It's also help to come up. And you can see now how, why. Not why. The pull. I like the relatively wide pull. One, and you see it's very shallow, and another one, so very shallow. You can see when he's pulling, he doesn't change anything with his body position. No. Nothing, almost nothing, and the head in the streamline, everything in the streamline. You know, it's something like if you have a boat. The paddle is working, but the boat doesn't, the shape, body, the boat shape doesn't move anything. The boat shape, you have to do almost the same thing. The shape, almost straight. Not so tightly, of course. And this is the end of the pool, but start the insert. When you do the insert, it's very important things. The fingers should be always on the front, because someone doing like this. And from here until here, your body is moving, I don't know how many centimeters, maybe 30, 40 centimeters, it's made as resistance. With this part, if you hold your hands like this, you can make more. This is our goal. With every movement, move forward and forward and forward and faster too. And also, if your fingers on the front is much easier. Another thing, Sam. Something wrong? Something wrong.
Just show some character.
In the instep, when your hands closer than your shoulders, after you have to move your shoulders. Read your shoulders, not just like this. This is also resistance. Go in together, not like this. This is the worst part. It's really tricky because if your swimmers do like this, pour the water and catch the water and get tired from nothing. You don't need to push the water together because it doesn't work to move forward. You have to move forward. And also you have to move hands and shoulders and elbows. And when you move from here, you just do the, like the lunge forward, the hands first, not the head. Not the head first. Hands, elbows, shoulders, and head. And last time I looked at the details more. Now you have not too much time. This is the simple, very important things. Lift up your shoulders. Not just lift it up, closer. Closer to your ear. Not here. This is not here. Here. Because you see, this is both sides is more than 5 and 10 centimeters wider. Need everything just like in. The difference is not too much. This picture made 1979. And when I teach my swimmer, I told him, you move on the surface, on the same, try to keep yourself on the same level, because I don't see under your arm. It's a stupid thing, but it's worth because you move forward without anything, it's almost possible. But this is only just one trick, but then you'll be careful. And this is the covering. And another question, how you can keep your height? You can keep your height if you just see let's look from behind. And the next step. And the last step. And how you can keep your height? Somebody has a talent, it's easy, but not everybody has. You can help yourself if when you take your hands on the front, the palm face down, this low surface, it's not enough, but it's good to help hold yourself. If you do like this, you will sink, sure. If you do like this, maybe you can hold the same height, but finally you have to turn out. This is a normal. This is a normal for how everybody does. This is a normal thing. This is once switch and twist, and then another twist. The whole rest of it is not that really comfortable. So, you know, don't be surprised if you have something strange. And also, if you want to keep your height, it's not enough, just enough to go straight forward. At the same time, not just take your hands and take your shoulders and elbows and shoulders and head. Take it and lift it. Take it and lift it at the same time. If you just take it, it's really just go down. Not so deeply, but go down. Have it all the way. take it and lift it, maybe we just a nice land on the surface. This is our goal. If you have a good speed, it's easier to do it. Because for example, for the feet, the breaststrokers has no time to swing, sink. The 200 breaststroke is different because the 200 breaststroke is usually longer stroke, you need to take much more, longer. It has a time to sink. Now, let's go to the breaststroke kick. I make this picture here, 2008, this pool, 25 pool. Last time I have a question, who said why the knees position make more resistant than the narrow? And now I have the same questions. Who said the right knees make more resistance than the narrow? Answer please. Well, doesn't matter. Only one thing matters. It's very serious. The angle between your body. This is your body. This is your leg. Doesn't matter where you are. Legs. This is the butt. Shoulder. The head. This is the very important thing. You teach for the kids. Don't pull up your knees purposely. Just pull up your feet, not the knees. Everybody does. How much? Because many swimmers, many good swimmers, pull up the knees like this. This is resistance. And I'm sure if somebody swims like this, this different, like minimum 2 seconds for Fiji, the same power. Very important. With this, this. It's not easy to do it if somebody has a talent and if it doesn't realize it, it doesn't do purposely. But when you teach the kids, you care for the kids, kids, don't pull up your knees, just pull up your feet behind your body. Behind. You see? He's pulling up the feet in the shadow, not wider than the hips. And when the kick, when the feet is coming closer and closer and closer to the butt, in the last third, this way, last third, you need to speed up and take on the right spot. If you take the right spot is same your heels. Between your heels should be almost same or same like your knees, because you can turn out your feet if it's wide. If not wide and your knees too close, it's not possible to turn it out. Only just 45 degrees. You will turn out just half of it. You miss the first half, plus you make a big resistance before. I forgot to say these are important things. Anytime you can stop me, anytime. Anybody has any questions, because now I'm really running faster and faster, and I don't explain everything. This is what we need to do, 45 degrees with the feet, plus the not air, 45 degrees with the, hips, if you open your knees, and I don't explain why, you have to do it. This is when the real breaststroke kick starts. Turn out the feet perfectly, a little bit more. Because if your feet is not up to 190 degrees out, the water will push you on the side, sure. And also, I didn't say why you need to speed up a little bit before you turn out. Because if you do slowly, it's really hard to stand up when you're in your spot. If you do quickly, what it says, pull you back. Just learn automatically the first order. Sure. See, you cannot stop down if you go down very quickly. This is only one reason why you need to go. But at the same time, don't pull up your knees. And also, the question is, how wide the kick? Of course, the narrow is better if you can turn out the feet perfectly. Not your new divider. Because this is more important, because you will pull the water by feet, not with your legs. This part, the lower, doesn't count too much. You know, we count something, but it's almost nothing. And also, we feel the water by hands, like here, by hands, by fingers, same thing with the feet. You don't feel anything, you know, too much here. Not under our control, just we are doing the shape, what we think is good. No, something about the... But this angle is good, see? There. You see his hands moving forward on the surface, on the top, not sinking forward. And this. Okay. And his feet so close to his spot. Right? Like this one. This picture, I don't know who is here, I think it's English. From the World Championship, somewhere in the middle. He was in the top five short. Can you see? He's pulling up, doing so much. So let's see now the best technical. The girls better. She's the worst. She was the 100 world record holder. And she's the best. Okay, you know? It's very nice. Doesn't make too much resistance. And this is how wide someone, you know, the best swimmers, knees and the feet. And also, if you try something like this, you have no power here. If you see the weight in first, you can see everybody's doing like this and moving just a little bit and standing up. Imagine nobody trying this. Nobody trying this. Everybody tried the feet and the knees almost in the same distance. Well, those guys know better than the other. You have to listen and learn from another sports. But another thing, we don't need so much power, but I will explain in the next hour why we need to. And this is just pictures about the number of feet. And one more before. The body positions. This is good because she's not yet starting the hip, just maybe one moment before, but the knees already very on a very nice spot. She's good. Too much resistance. You know, because in our sports, we are fighting between two things. Make the resistance and don't make resistance. Make the resistance by hands and with the feet, but no make resistance with anything else. This is really hard, but don't really say for everyone. Well, this is from the competition, the body position is lunging forward on the top, and you cannot see, but if you want, you can see the hands also, not so deep, and the whole body, not so deep too. It's happened in the 200, it's much harder to do than in the 100. This is the last 5 meters at the Olympic Games many years ago, but you see, he tried to keep the same good position in every stroke in the final. Another very important thing, do the good technique in the final paper much more than in the first 25. Every time, if your swimmer is swimming like a 200 breaststroke, and pass for her or him, the most important thing is your technique in the last 50. Because in the last 50, many swimmers try just maybe finish. Of course, everybody tried to finish. But in the finish, everybody retired, doesn't really feel the water, doesn't doesn't feel anything, just fighting in the elements, fighting in the water. But somebody has ambitions to do the right things, it's paid much more than in the first field. You know, usually in the first field, you're not too much different. Somebody will be a bit slower or faster, a bit different, but everybody able to do a good first field. It's not a big deal. Maybe in the last field, in the third field, the first of all, and in the last field. This is the real question. Technically, should be the best, relatively the best of the relative. This is the reason why you need to practice in the good technique if our singer is tired in the training. This is also a nice position, you see? And the palm face down and just moving forward and parallel, not too deeply. And that's it. I don't, if you have any questions about the technique, I talk about the technique, but last time we talked about 2 hours. And anybody have any questions about any technical or in the breast talk? No.
Yes. Why is it different from the men and the women when you see this technique that men are still not as superior?
Now, why
the technique is better for us to do this mass and weight of the men and the flexibility of
Your question is why now, on the like after 2000, the breast or the worst technique is better than the worst?
Is it due to size, mass?
No, it's from the coaches. The same coach seemed the best talented breaststrokers, now the members better than that. Only from that. It's not because the breaststroke, like a technique, like a style, more fit for the woman body. No, it's yeah. But you know what? Almost everybody coming from the coach. If you see a good coach somewhere, the same good coach not there, maybe in another city, things really very different. It's not, of course, you need to, you know, find the talented kids, and but in the average, if you see the long time period, like 20 years. Up to the coaches. This is the finish movement in the breaststroke. You know, everywhere, if you see the breaststrokers, everywhere, everybody can do mistakes. You know, for example, here, many breaststrokers does never finish just the kick. Like this, higher, lower, and the most common things. The feet, the top is not pointing, something like that. Every small thing count, because if you see how many mistakes possible to do in the breaststroke, if somebody doing a sloppy stroke, if somebody doing a really super nice stroke, it's just technical things made like 10 seconds or more in 100 series. But the good technique is physically not so easy. You need to use muscles, hold yourself, do something, not just like a breaststroke. Well, no, any other questions?
Joseph,
yes.
What's your impression on the dolphin kick at the end of the breaststroke?
End of the breaststroke?
Yeah, with the dolphin
kick. That is not legal.
Yeah.
We can talk about it, but why we need to talk about it is not legal.
What's
it's the extra things.
Because I think Olympic Games, you can see some of the swimmers underwater video doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
First of all, I don't agree with the new, it's not new, with the Freenard rule and Freenard reset. The backstroker can turn on freestyle. Why? I don't get it. Why? And because it's a really interesting thing, how someone can do the backstroke, turn on the backstroke. Really, really good. And now freestyle. And another thing, the butterfly kick in the breaststroke. It came from the underwater stroke, because many swimmers do the breaststroke pull out this way. If you do this way, not too much on the side, it's action reaction. The whole body move a little bit. Of course, somebody take a power a little bit for the dolphin kick. It was not legal. And I don't know when exactly, what happened around 2000, maybe not earlier. Fina said, okay, Grasshopper can do one butterfly kick. And that time everybody, almost everybody did the butterfly kick before the pull up. It's no sense. And also, why somebody can do butterfly kick in the Grasshopper? Why maybe so? I don't know. No, Grasshopper. Pull kick, pull, same for everyone. And because now, many Grasshopper do. One before, one after, and sometimes one more after. Like in 2012, one of the best after the dark. Nobody can realize that it was happened so quickly, and the splash, and the judge cannot use video. Somebody made two or three butterfly people.
Can we make four or five?
That's seriously.
Beat someone who did
not. Yeah. And it's made different. Not just because it's faster, no. It's made with rhythm. But my opinion is, I measure it. If somebody has a push of the wall from here, and do the butterfly kick here, and to do, start a pull out here, this is and do the butterfly kick here, this is better than here, because you have a speed, good speed, faster than you said, faster speed. No any sense to do anything, because for the first butterfly kick, you need to preparate your body, not just coming from something. No. First of all, you do something like this. You will slow down, and you will speed up again with the butterfly kick. And this is a cheat yourself, because now you feel this is a good kick because it's working. Of course working. If you're slowing down more and more and more, it still work more. This is a really tricky thing. The same thing if somebody after the dive from here going down first so deeply and feel the water so good from here. Of course, because you're already too slow here. Of course you will feel this part. But if you don't go down, down, just like this, change the reaction, this will be a bit faster and longer. Not because this is a longer way, because this is not too much dynamic lifting power pushing down and backwards. This is very rare if you go down first. But same thing, if you do the butterfly kick before, you feel it's good. But you have to prepare it yourself. But usually, you do something like this, this is like a help. Go in the water, and you say for your swimmers, okay, let's climb out from the pool. Everybody move like this. Help, you need your help here. It's coming automatically. Same like the butterfly kick. Everybody do the butterfly kick, does it, but butterfly kick from the same spot. But need the help. It doesn't need help here before the pull out, because we are already. It's my opinion. Everything gets my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong. But, you know, I told you, everybody can see anything, everybody can do anything, but finally, we have to do it. Well, more questions? Yes?
That's okay.
Yeah.
What I traditionally was taught in swinging, right?
Almost, yeah.
Yeah. Then the technique that I saw some Japanese swimming was that.
You know, it's very, 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 you know, many things very, very dangerous, because if somebody, a good swimmer, world record holder, everybody says, this is the model, this is the best. But maybe not, because you just think, this is the feet, this is the knees. If you pull up your feet like this, this is resistance, much more than this. It's no question, because this part behind the part, this is not. Somebody is good at this? Yes, maybe. Same like Rebecca Sony. Rebecca Sony was a great swimmer, world record holder, Olympic champion, and she sent like this. And her coach said, I don't want to change her, I don't touch her technique, because she's already in the best. And he was right, because it was in her person, you know, this is the base. or her. And you know, if somebody sent like this, and only just 20 or 30 or 100 place in the world, you have to change it, no question. You have not any other choices and no risk. But to change her stroke was risky because you know, she was the best, but she needed to change, no. But it's still wrong. This is right?
Illegal.
And sometimes, yeah.
Yeah.
And well, we need to build up everything on the personality, on the hard drive. You know, if you teach a monkey to walk on two legs, it's happened. The monkey was in the cage, and the monkey was I don't know how many years old, but every day the monkey was out and walking on two legs with the people, with the man, in the zoo. And the test was, make a fire in the cage and wait for some seconds, maybe half a minute. And the monkey was just crazy. And then open the cage, the monkey run by. This was in the hard drive, in the hard situation. Well, for us also, if you're a swimmer, the swimmer has different movements, personal movement. If not really necessary, don't change. Let's build up everything in the personal movements, in the personal. It's my opinion.